Namami Pavitram Charitam Yasyah Pavitram Jivanam Tatha Pavitrata Swarupim Yei Tasyai Devyei Namo Namaha Kalindi Pullakamale Madhavena Kridharata Brahmanandam Namastutyam Sadguru Lokanayaka Offering my salutations to the Holy Trinity and to Most Revered Swami Brahmanji Maharaj. My pranams to all the senior monks present here. My pranams to Swami Shantatma Jagadayas and Sri Sharif Mamaji. My pranams to the secretary of the center for having invited me to share some thoughts with you on this important topic, Sri Ramakrishna, the Holy Mother in our daily life. Just a few incidents, so that our devotion, our faith and our conviction in Sri Ramakrishna and Mother will be re-authenticated, will be renewed and will become very, very strong and fresh for future. Is Sri Ramakrishna just a historical personality, lived between 1836 and 1886? Or is he living today? Is he a guiding force? Is he our compass? Is he our umbrella? I'm overwhelmed to listen to the experiences of Sharif Mamadji, how Sri Ramakrishna lives and guides every moment of our life, provided we anchor ourselves in him. One very interesting incident. It can be mystical, it can be devotional. It happened in the 1970s. A disciple of Revered Swami Vireshwaranji Maharaj was somewhere. There is no center in her part of the town. The nearest is Mangalore. But then this lady, this devotee, does the worship of Sri Ramakrishna. There is a very beautiful shrine of Sri Ramakrishna in her home. Meditates, does her japa, and she offers rice payasam that we all often do in our centers. She kept the rice payasam in front of Sri Ramakrishna and went out to attend a phone call. After a few minutes, there was a very sweet fragrance pervading the entire home. She was surprised, she was thrilled, she was shocked. She asked the servant maid or somebody else in the house, has anybody lighted agarbatti? There was nobody to do it. It was at 12:30 in the afternoon. Then she went inside and saw the top layer of the payasam is missing. She was confused. And immediately her first thought was to talk to her guru, the 10th president of the order, on Sri Ramakrishna Jayanti, in Belur Math. Swami Vireshwaranji, busy with taking pranams and blessing the devotees. Thousands will be there. But she made it a point to talk to his secretary, Swami, Swami Prameyanandaji. And he said, today it is not possible. Please call tomorrow. Kal phone kijiye, abhi kyon, abhi kaisa hota hai? Maharaj toh vyast hai, pranams le raha hai, hazar hazar bhakt hai, Ramakrishna Jayanti hai. She did not listen. She cried and said, 1 minute only with my guru. Theek hai, half an hour ke baad phone kijiye. Then Vireshwaranji himself, our Sangha Guru himself, talked to her and said, main baad mein baat karunga. After 4 o'clock, Maharaj calls her and says, "You are blessed. Today, Thakur has accepted your bhajan." Her life dhanya ho gaya. This is where Sri Ramakrishna comes in our daily life and says, "Dive deep, dive deep, dive deep, oh my mind. Why are you searching for glass beads in the market of life? Dub, 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 man, rup, shagore." And he gives a beautiful example of how a man wanted to dig a well, goes 10 feet inside the earth and finds rocks. Kuch nahi milta hai unko. His mind says, "Find out another place, 10 feet. He finds clay, mind says, "No water." Another 10 feet, some other place. 10 places he digs 10 feet, till a engineer comes and says, "You fool, in one place you should go 100 feet, you will definitely get water." How he solves the problems of the bhaktas in our daily life. It's amazing that Vivekananda himself says, one story of Sri Ramakrishna, I can go on speaking about it for days and days together. The highest advaita he has put it in our daily life. He has made it so simple. And on the other hand, how our Sangha, the Sangha Gurus and the Bhaktas have led this life, holding on to Sri Ramakrishna. As Sri Ramakrishna said, bahut baar bola tha, Katha Amrita mein, Bhakte Hriday Bhagavanir Baitak Kana bola tha. If you find, if you want to find God, see Him in a devotee's heart. The Lord resides there. Another true example of how Sri Ramakrishna is connected to us in our daily life, not occasional life. Nityotsavam bhavattesha nityashri nityamangalam yad hridisto bhagavan mangalayatano hari. The day we install the Lord in our heart, that day becomes Utsava, festival, Nitya Utsava. That day will become Nitya Shri. That day will become Nitya Mangalami, ever auspicious. Because Hari is the embodiment of auspiciousness. Mangalayatana is Sri Ramakrishna. 1970s, I've read this in the story, in the books, of again our 10th Guru Swami Vireshwaranji. Heavy floods in Bengal, Durga Puja time. People are not able to get food in different districts of Howrah. And the news comes on the Puja day to Revered Maharaj. His heart melts for the people. And convening a trustees meeting, he sees that all the rice bags meant for Kichudi Prasadam are sent to that relief center for the welfare of the people who are suffering. And another senior Swamiji had told me, "Maharaj, why are you doing this?" He said, "Sri Ramakrishna did it in his life. He did not go further into Devgarh to see Mahadeva Shiva. He said, 'Shiva is here,' and made Mathurnath bring extra money for food and clothing of that people." Another great example that I can tell in our daily life, when I was a brahmachari, under the care of Revered Swami Ranganathanji Maharaj, he asked me to take care of the kitchen and the garden of the Hyderabad Math. And one portion of the Hyderabad mat was very, very bad condition, full of rocks and uneven ground. We had hired some workers to level the ground. 15 rupees or 20 rupees per day that time, 1990s, per person. Very little money they would get. And Maharaj in the evening used to walk. And he found one lady was having a tiny baby of 4 or 5 months. He is tying that baby in a cloth between two coconut trees, going to the work and coming back, feeding that baby, nursing that baby, again going to work. And by that time, Revered Raghunathanji was the vice president, Sangha Guru of the order. And look at what enters into him. I was looking after that land leveling. Maharaj ne humko bulaya. Hey, abhi jao market go. Ek feeding bottle lekar aao. The Sangha Guru, vice president, and he is telling me to bring a feeding bottle. The fool that I was, went to the market, brought a feeding bottle, and when he saw the feeding bottle, he told me, get hot milk in this, warm milk. I brought it from the kitchen, and adding that milk into that bottle, it was so heavy. It was a glass bottle. He held it in his hand, weighed it for a few seconds and hit me on the head and said, you fool, this feeding bottle is not for you, it is for that baby. How will she hold it? Go and exchange it. Immediately I had to take a cycle and run to the, move to the shop, exchange that feeding bottle for a plastic one. And now he said, now the baby can hold. The story doesn't end here. What hit me on my head was, how Sri Ramakrishna and Mother enters into these great souls and teaches us directly or indirectly. And it said, this Sangha Guru, vice president who traveled all the world, one of the classic orators and messengers of the Ramakrishna order, is sitting on the footpath holding that baby in his lap and trying to feed that baby. What a picture, what a situation. Why will the baby obey to him? Baby will not obey. It was playing its pranks and crying loudly. Maharaj doesn't know Telugu. I know Telugu. He said, tell the mother what I am telling her. It was an interpretation of how to nurse a baby with feeding bottle. 1 hour lecture. Man at 5:45 will give Bhagavad Gita talk and now he is teaching a village woman how to feed a baby with a feeding bottle. And later when I asked him, he said, mother did much more, I did only one. This was the lesson we learned from these great masters. So Sri Ramakrishna lives, mother lives, and it is the responsibility of our devotees and all of us together, because it is a sangha of the devotees and the monks, organized by Sri Ramakrishna himself, conducted beautifully through Holy Mother. One important thing I would tell you, as devotees, my personal experience dealing with children is not that good today. Things are going out of focus. So it is our responsibility to give proper, nutritious education and values of Ramakrishna Mother to our devotees. If you are a devotee coming through your mother and father, it is our duty and your duty to give that lesson, that sensitivity to our children. It's a very interesting story, a real incident which happened in America, which has come out in a book form by name Dibs in Search of the Self, by Dr. Virginia Axline. It's a personal experience. They're a 5-year-old boy. No mother, no father. Though they are there, they have no love towards the baby. Love towards the child. He has no identity. He has no education. He has no language. When he goes to school, he's thinking he's a third person. He behaves like an animal. He bites. He scratches. He shouts, he yells, there's no bhasha. It took 7 years for the psychologist, Virginia Axline, to make him understand his self. On the 12th year of his birthday, that boy, young boy by name Dibs, innocently says, I like to eat. The first birthday was celebrated when he was 12 years old. This is the truth today. When we say Ramakrishna, when we say Vivekananda, when we say Mother Sharada, is it not our responsibility to go and teach this? give that spiritual sensitivity to our children. Because Shankara beautifully said in the Viveka Chodamani, Durlabham Trayameveta Daivanugraha Hetukam Manushyattvam Mumukshyattvam Mahapurusha Samshrayaha. Three things are very rare to get. Bahut durlabh hai. Ek cheez to manushyatva hai. After millions and millions of years of evolution of this planet, we have got this human birth. But Vivekananda beautifully says, psychologically says, animality, pashutvam jo man mein hai, wo bahirgat ho raha hai aajkal. Manushyatva mein jo choice hamare paas hai, reverse gear laga kar wapas ja sakta hai jungle ko. Ab top gear laga ke adhyatmik vikas ko ja sakta hai. We are at a threshold of choices. Too many things, bahut kuch hai. But mumukshuttam mahapurusha samshraya hum logo ko ye aana chahiye. That is why the flow of spiritual values, whether through a game, whether through a lecture, whether in the school or out of the school, sweeten our life with these attitudes. And if we talk about Holy Mother for just a minute or two, from the broomstick till the pussycat, which did not come to drink the milk meant for Sri Ramakrishna. From Hamsa the dacoit to Vivekananda, Brahmananda and Sharadananda, our love was so vast and so deep and so intense. And when somebody brought a big twig of a amlaki tree, Mother felt pain. She is teaching us environmental protection. And she is teaching us waste management in our daily life. If the skin is available, give to the cows. If the vegetables are available, if the cow is not there, give to a dog. Put it in a pond, fish will eat. Or give it to somebody. It can become manure today in waste management. So Mother's teachings are not just for worship, not just for glorification or quoting, it is for application. As we just conclude, two important things I will share and complete my ideas. If we have to make Sri Ramakrishna our own, where do we meditate? Kahan dhyan sakta hai? Apart from the temple, go back to what Swami Abhedanji writes. Hridaya kamala madhye rajitam nirvikalpam sada sada kila bhedat atitam ekaswarupam prakriti vikriti shunyam nityam anandamurtim vimala paramahamsam ramakrishnam bhajamaha. Let us meditate on Ramakrishna in our heart. Hridaya kamala madhye. And if I have to see Mother in my daily life, feel the presence of the Jagannamata of Saraswati, remember what the drunkard Padma Vinod sang in Udbodhan when the doors were closed on the order of Swami Sharadanandaji. Utago Karunamayi Kologo Kutir Dwar. Oh Mother, you are sleeping in the palace when I am struggling in darkness. And the Mother graciously opened her doors and gave vision to Padma Vinod. And what did he sing? He irritated Swami Sharadanandaji. Dost, you see Mother and Mother will see me. Let not the dost see her. That Mother alone can understand. So in all our life, we have to go dive deep into Mother, into Ramakrishna, find their living presence. And last point I would just say is, the boat should be on the water, water should not be in the boat. Live in the samsara, samsara should not live in you. That is simplification and attitude that we have towards Ramakrishna, towards Ma Sharada, and towards all the other disciples of this holy order. Jai Ramakrishna.